Hi friends, this is Shiva. Today we are going to discuss about database testing in session 2. Please subscribe my channel before watching. So this video is continuation of previous video. In previous video we have discussed about the basics of our database management systems, and now we are going to discuss about how to install and configuration Oracle 11g and TOD for Oracle and data types. And we are going to write TDL commands. We are going to create the table with not null constraint, check constraint, default constraint. Sorry, default is not a constraint, default is a keyword, and in Oracle. So use of like keyword in create table, and use of between keyword in create table, and how to use not equal to in the create table. So these are things we are going to discuss today, right? So there is a link I have shared in previous video also. If you have not done, so I will show you properly now. So go to your browser, place this link. I will share this link in the comment box. So there is a green color button. You can click on download. Once you have clicked download, you will get one zipped file. See here, this zipped file you will get. So once you extract this zipped file, you will get this disk one folder. There is a setup. So the same way I have I'm showing this. So disk one, so when you go inside, there is a setup file. When you double click on the setup file, you will get this window. So click on next, then I accept terms and license agreement, and click on next, and click on Oracle Database 11g Express Edition. So this Express Edition is free to use, so it's not a commercial purpose. We are doing for the learning purpose, so you can install and you can use it. This is for free. And here you have to insert your password. We are going to use this password while you are going to connect the database, so keep remember this password while installing, or note somewhere so that it will be useful to you when you are going to connect your database. And click on install. So it will take maximum 1 minute before it will complete, so you can click on finish. Then there is a window. So what we are going to do is we will open the SQL client first, right? So go to command prompt. So or in the search box you can type SQL command. So when it's installed properly, this window will appear. So you just click and you can type here connect. So this will show you username and password. See, basically when we are installing the database, there will be one username. So here if you see this window, you can able to see there are two usernames, right? SYS and system. You can use any one of the username to connect the database. So the password is same. So this is, and system are the admins of your database, so that these guys will have full access in the database, right? So here I am going to give username as system. So system. Then I will give my password. So usually this password will not be shown, and so your SQL connected properly. So now what we need to do is we will check whether it is connected properly or not. So you can execute this command, select star from tabs. So now it will take all the system related tables, and it will executing now. So it will take 2 to 5 seconds. So once it's so now it is done. Now our SQL installed properly. So you have to come out properly. You have to click you have to type exit, then you can click enter, because that session you should terminate, otherwise this session also will run in background. So again it will create slowness in your system, right? So you should not continue like that. So now our client is executed properly. So now what we are going to do is, so there is some GUI also. You should just copy it, the link, and paste it over there. So basically this will be TOAD for Oracle. You can able to search Google also. So if you found any good tool like TOAD, that also you can use. So there is some you have to register here, whether Windows, then 64 bit or 32 bit. So you have to give your credentials, name, first name, last name. So once you register and click on download, it will download your file. It's a normal installation, it won't take anything. You just where is downloads, right? So here it will come up with this folder, so Toad for Oracle trial version, right? So it's available for only 30 days because it is you cannot use this version after 30 days. I think we can increase the number of days also. You can try it for somebody for learning purpose, you can use it. Otherwise we can use SQL client, so that is permanently free only, so that you can use it for executing and learning purpose, right? So when this is normal one, once you have installed, you will get this icon over there, right? So when you double click, it will open one window. So there we are going to configure. So in SQL client, it will show user ID and password, that we know already. So here it will take, so in username, you have to give system, then password, the system password. Like while installing, we have given something, right? So you have to give that. So this is my password. Then in the database, you have to select XE. So by default, XE. Then here also, connection string also XE. Then when you click connect, it will connect with the database. Right, so now it has connected. Right, so this is the way we can configure. Right, so we'll come to this point later. So we will continue with the our stuff. Okay, so now we have installed and checked whether it is working properly or not. So both things are fine now. So we are good on it. So here we are going to check the data types in Oracle. Right, so basically, there are three kinds of data types. One is string, another one is numeric, another one is date data type. So when you use char of size, which means fixed size, you can able to store maximum of 2000 bytes. So you can take like that, one English alphabet will take 1 byte to store the, it 1 byte memory it will take to store. So when you want to store M or F, one character, see, I will tell you when we can go for the character type. See, basically, when you declare char of 10, which means that you can able to store 10 characters, right? So, for example, you want to store welcome. So now, this has 7 characters, right? So, W, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So, there are 7 characters. So basically, it should take only 7 characters, but in this character data type, it is fixed size. So it will take whole 10 bytes. So another 3 bytes will not be available for storing the another character. It won't leave. So the whole 10 bytes it will occupy when you declare char of 100, but when you try to store only 2 characters, so another 98 bytes will not be available, right? So it is used to store only fixed values. Why? Because so another the 3 characters will be occupied by the trailing space. So it will take only 7 characters. Another 3 characters means which 3 bytes will be occupied by trailing spaces. So will not be available for another storage. So here I have explained very clearly. Another 3 characters will be occupied by trailing spaces. So we cannot use for that those 3 bytes. That's what. See, when you are going to store M or F, it will take maximum of 1 byte. So you can store it. So when you know the maximum size of the character, yes, you can go with the character. Otherwise, you can go with the varchar data type. So varchar of 10 means, which will take 10 bytes to store. So it will take only 7 characters, means 7 bytes, and the 3 bytes will be relieved for another storage. So if any data type required to store the remaining 3 characters, yes, it is available in the varchar 2 10 data type. So that's the difference between character 10 and varchar 2 of 10, right? Okay, so if you have any doubt, please comment it, I can explain you. So the another one is numeric data types. Basically, in Oracle there is a data type called number, right? So it has 2 parameters. One is P, another one is S. P means precision, S means scale, which means that, so here I have given the explanation of scale, right? So scale identifies the number of digits allowed in the floating point, which means that I will explain. So here I have one example. I will explain clearly. So precision means subtraction of precision and scale. I will come to the example. So here I have declared numeric of 6, 4, which means that so this first part is integer part, the second part is the floating part, right? So there is some calculation when you subtract 6 minus 4, which means that here I have explained subtraction of precision and scale. So 6 minus 4, which will give you 2. So in integer part you can store maximum of 2 characters, which means that 99. If you give 100, it will throw the error because it won't do the round off, right? It will truncate, right? So here the second part, 4, which means that you want to store 4 characters in the floating point. See here. So this is what I'm trying to explain here. See here. So 6 minus 4, 2. So you can store maximum of 2 characters, 2 digits, and there are 4 digits you can store in the after floating point, right? So the second thing, when you declare numeric of 6, right? So it will allow 6 integer part and you cannot store the floating point, it will round off. And when you declare only numeric, no limitation in the integer part and floating part. So that's what I'm giving the definition here. So scale identifies the number of digits allowed in the floating point, and subtraction of precision and scale, right, identifies the number of digits allowed in the integer part. That's what here I have given an example to explain that, right? So if you have any doubt, please comment it below so I can explain clearly. And day data type. So here there is a data type called date. It will store the date. So here that's format of the date is DD, then first three characters of month. For example, if we are to store January, it must be JAN, then FEB, then MER. So it must be like that, right? So you have to do like that. Then there is a special keyword in Oracle is null. So the null means unknown, which means that in the table, you can consider this table. So now this mobile, Huawei mobile, we don't know the value at the, so we don't know the value of the Huawei. So that's why we are putting null, which means that the value which is currently unknown, which so that we can put as the null, which means that so you cannot put zero. Because you can say that it's an integer value, I can put zero. No, zero means value. So you can equate zero with zero. But in Oracle, if you put null, you cannot equate null with another null also. That's what I have given. Null will not be equal to with another null, right? So we cannot equate null with the any value. So which means that the value which is currently unknown is null. That's why we are giving null. It's a special type. So you cannot you cannot say price equal to null. The system will not show any error, but you will not get the exact data, right? That's why there's a special condition is there to check the nullable, which means is null, right? So when you give is null as a condition, it will give only this record, right? So null means unknown, right? If I have any doubt, please comment it, I can explain that. So now we are going to create the table. This is the syntax of the creation table. So in Oracle, it's a case insensitive language. So SQL is a case insensitive. So it won't consider the any capital letters, small letters, something like that. So it will execute. But the thing is that the table data is sensible. For example, if you are storing here, Vivo. So the first letter is capital, right? So it must be first letter capital, then only it will identify. So table data is sensitive and that language is case insensitive, right? So now I will create one table here. So you can create table. So I want to create the table name is create table student, right? So usually Oracle will expect that semicolon, but without also it will execute, that not an issue, but it's a basic syntax. So create table, table name. So here I want to, what I want to do is student ID. So here I want to give one more data type is integer. So if you know that value only integer, you can put directly integer, student ID and student name. Here I want to give varchar to 20. Why? Because the name will vary. We cannot guarantee the name will have only 10 characters, 15 characters. So that's what we are giving, where name is varchar to 30. Then I want to give gender. So I am going to have only one character. So here one character. So that it will accept only M or F, right? So I have not applied any condition. I will apply, you know, after executing the creation of table. So then I want to give marks before we can give date of birth also, that is data type. And I want to create one more column is marks. So I want to give integer, right? So here I have created one table. So if you see here, every column should be segregated by comma, and the student ID, student name, gender, date of birth and marks. So every column segregated by commas, then the student name is maximum of 30 characters, right? So when you execute this, so there is a execution button to execute here. So you have to select and you have to execute. So the name is already used by the existing object. So the student table is already there. So we can delete this. So draw table. So this student, now this command will delete the created already existing table. So now the table got deleted. If you see here, table dropped. So you can get, right? So I will execute this command. The table is created. So now I want to execute the same command in the SQL also. So I will drop this because the both are going to use the same connection. So let me copy this and no, I will close this. We can close this also. So now I will open, because if you are not able to install the TOAD, so you have to work with this command prompt only. So you can use connect, username is system, then use your password, right? So here you can, so here I have copied, right? When you click right click, it will be pasted, okay? So here when you enter, table here also will create, right? So if you want to see the structure, DESE is one of the command. If you can put student, so it will give you the structure of the table, right? Student ID number 38, then student name is 30, the gender is 1. So basically the 38 bit precision, which means that, so integer, decimal, number, so by default that will support the maximum of 38 bit precision. So 38 digits it will support. So name already we have given, gender is char of 1. So here you can able to see here, right? So the same command, whatever the command we have executed in that GUI, that also we have executed. So draw table student. So you can delete also, yeah? So table has been dropped. You can exit here because it's not flexible to edit all those things. That's what I'm using this application TOAD. So it's launching now. It will come with one small sound. So here you can give your password. You can connect, because the same thing you have to give, because already I have given system and connection string and all. So it will take automatically. So now I have created this table, right? So how I want to insert some values. So don't worry about insert command and all. I will explain in the next video. So here we are focusing on, while creating the table, I want to give some constraints. That's what I am focusing here. Insert into the table name is student, right? So values, right? So integer is student ID is integer, so I want to give 101, and the student name I want to give Tom, and gender is one character, so I want to give male, and date of birth, so I want to give sys date, and marks is just in the sense it will take the current date, and marks is I want to give 75, right? So and you can copy this, you can paste multiple times. This is not possible in your SQL client, so we cannot edit, we cannot edit very easily, so that's why I'm using this application. So here I want to give some name called Mark. So okay, this is fine. Now you can select these three commands and you can execute it. So now you can able to see there are three rows created, one row created, one row. So at a time you can execute only one statement, so SQL will execute one by one only. It cannot be all the three records cannot be executed at the same time, right? Okay, so three records we have inserted. So if you want to see that all the three records, so you can write select star from student. So now when you execute this statement, you can able to see those three records. See here, if you click a grid, you can able to see the table of data. And if you want to see here output, yes, here also this output is similar to your SQL client, so the same way it will show, so there is no error. So grid, so this is what creation of table along with the inserting the data. And okay, so now we will apply some constraints in the table. So we will go one by one, go with the, so as per the content, not null constraint, right? So what I want to do is we'll do one thing. Let me delete this table so that draw table student. So now I want to delete this table. So when you click drop table, so it will be deleted. Okay, so what I want to do is student ID, it must have some value, so I want to give not null, right? So when you select and you can execute, so the table has been created. Now for the third student, I want to give null value, right? So so also you have to remember string value should be enclosed by single quotes. So you just select and you can execute. First row has been created and second row also created. One second, we'll see whether second row or third row executed. Two rows, grid 101, 102. Then I want to execute the third row. You just click it. Oh god, click it, select and execute. So this will what happened, because we have given not null, right? If you can able to see, cannot insert null into the system dot student or student ID, because we have given not null, right? That's what. So you cannot insert null value to the not null constraint. So this is what about not null constraint, right? So here one more thing is there, syntactically we can do like this. So constraint is the keyword, right? So constraint, I want to give it's a stud underscore id, then not null constraint. So the constraint is one of the keyword constraint, and we are giving constraint name. So when the table has constraint name, so in future if you want to remove this not null constraint, right, so you should know this constraint name to delete. So this is the reason we are having the constraint and constraint name. So this is a user defined one, so no need to worry about any syntax. So without this part also this will work. So that's what, you know, the initially I did not give constraint and constraint name. So just it's a reference for the this not null constraint of this student ID. That's why here student ID underscore not null constraint. So if you want to delete the constraint in future, you can use this name to delete. So I will explain this when you're going to work on drop. That time I will explain how to delete the constraint and all. So as of now, without this also this is possible, right? Okay, so this is called not null constraint. When you give not null, we cannot insert null value to the particular column. Okay? So if you want, I can I will drop this table and I will execute once so that you will come to know this key, this thing is working or not. So this will work, right? Okay, let me delete because I want to show you the different combinations for the single table. Instead of creating multiple tables, we can work with the same table. So now the second thing is check constraint. Okay, so now what I want to do is this gender should have only M or F. So here I can write check, so open bracket, then gender, there's a keyword called in, similar to or. In means it's or condition. It can be either M or it can be either F. So this will the now this column only support M or F, right? So now you can select and you can execute this. It will be executed. So it will support only now M or F, right? So other than that you cannot insert. So initially what I want to do is the first is M, then second one is F, and third one is I want to insert X, right? So you can insert, no error. Then second record you can insert, then third record you will get error. See here, so cannot insert null, right? So no, this is showing error for the null. So I will give you 103. It should give error for the check constraint violation, right? You have to execute this, it will show you. So check constraint violated because this will support only M or F. So other than that it won't support, right? So that's what I want to show you. We can restrict the column values while inserting the data, right? So we have to create the structure like this so that we can restrict, right? Okay, I have one more question. Can we insert null to the check constraint column? We'll check. So now I will insert. I will execute this. Yes, I can able to insert. You can execute three rows inserted. See here, I can insert null because there is no value. That's what that will be assumed by null, right? Okay. So we can insert null to the check constraint column. If you want to make it not null, yes. Now you cannot insert null to the date of birth column. It will show the error now. See here, name is already used to be the existing object. What happened? Okay. We will delete this. Let me delete this table because we edited the table, right? So you can execute this table. So here now I want to insert null to the this table. Now you cannot insert because we can modify that. If you give not null, so now you cannot insert null to the check constraint column, right? So this is what I want to show you here. So this is called check constraints. Just I will remove this. Okay. So now default keyword. So what is default? That's what. Say here I am giving not null constraint, check constraint. So here I have not used the constraint because Oracle will not be considered default as the constraint, right? So what I want to do is I want to give date of birth date default sys date. So sys date in the sense it will take the current date, right? So let me delete this table. So I think already I have dropped that table. So you can create the table. Yes, its table has created the default of system date. So when you want to give this date of birth the default, so you no need to give this value, because by default that value will be taken care. And I want to give mail, because we have given not null constraint, so it won't allow you to insert null. Also we need to consider one more. When you are going to give default values, you have to mention the columns, right? So you can copy this. Instead of typing, we can reduce the time. So student ID and student name. Where is that? Okay, student name and gender and anyhow data path is will be taken care automatically, because by default it will take a null value, and marks, right? So we are not inserting the date of birth, right? So it will taken care by it will taken automatically. So you can execute this. So by default it will take the system date. So you can execute this select statement to see the result whether that is taken or not. Yes, it has taken the system date. So also if you want to give some default value, for example here student values, instead of default value you want to give some other value. So where we need to insert? Before marks, right? Okay, so here I want to give 01 January 19, right? Date of birth. So now this will be taken automatically. So too many values. Okay, it must be the single quotes. Date must be in the single quotes. Okay, so you can execute this. What happened? Too many values. So insert into table name student ID, student name, gender. Okay, so already system date is there. That's what it is showing, that error. Okay, so now you can execute that statement to see the data. Now that record is inserted. So here what I am doing is, instead of default I am giving user defined value. So that value is now inserted. If you execute this, you can able to see there are two records. One is the today's date, one is the our inserted data, 1st Jan 2010. Okay, this is the format we have to use: DD, then MON, then YY. Then the third one is, we can insert null value to the default column. So if you want to give a null to the default, yes, we can able to insert also. You just select and execute this. Yes, that is inserted. Then when you execute this, you can able to see the null value in the our date of birth column, because we have inserted null. Okay, so this is what I want to show you in the default constraint. Then between keyword, right? So here what I want to do is let me delete this table. You can delete this. Okay, so marks, integer, check. So here also we need to use check. Marks between 0 and 100. So it will take both the values now, right? So now you can create this table. So now I want to insert 110 over here, right? So now this check constraint will stop you to execute, because there is an issue with the check constraint. You cannot insert 105, so it must be in the 0 to 100. So here you can able to insert now 90. So other than that, it won't allow you to insert. Okay, so I'll give you one small exercise to you. So So now, no, I will do it because you are, if you are learner, you cannot do. I will drop this. So now I want to check. Always this student ID should start with the capital S. So starting character always capital S. So what I want to do is check student ID like. So that's a keyword called like. So here you can put S percentile, which means that. So we are using wildcard symbol, so this also will be supported here. So which means that what will happen is, now your every student ID should start with the capital S. See, for example, I will execute this. I will execute this. It will show you the error because check condition violation, because the student ID always starts with the capital S. That's what it will allows you to insert only capital S. So here what I'm going to do is you can give capital S, and you have to do one more change over there. It must be string, because instead of integer you can give char also, that's not a problem. Char of 4 characters, right? So I want to give char of 4 characters. So before let me delete the table. So now the table got deleted. Now I will insert this, create the table. So now what we'll do is, so your table, so your table will check the student ID should start with the capital S. So now this row is created. When you execute this table, you cannot, because the, see here, check constant is violated, which means that, so here the data is not start with the S. So you may have some doubt. So here I will give string only. So I will give 101. Because you may think that you have declared here a character, but you are string in the numeric value. So now I'm giving double quotes. You can execute. It will show you there again, because check constraint violated. It will always check your name should start with the capital S. So S percentile means starts with. Okay. So this is what I want to show you today. So today we have seen also not equal to. So this is marks. You can use both the symbols. Marks should not be not equal to 0. Which means that you cannot insert the 0 to the marks value. See, for example, here I want to insert 0. So it won't allow you to insert 0. Because in the check constraint we are giving, it should not be not equal to 0, right? This is simple concept. So today we have discussed about not null constraint, check constraint with the different varieties, default keyword, then like keyword in the create table. So like we have used for the starts with S, then use of between keyword in the create table and not equal to table, right? So these are things we have seen today. So hope you like this video. So before ending this video, I want to show you. So tomorrow or next video, we'll discuss about primary key, foreign key, unique key, then alter and drop command. So these are the simple commands we can complete with a single video. Thanks for watching. Subscribe this video for more videos. Like this video and share this video for others so that they will get benefit. So thanks for watching.